Can you hear me okay?
Hey, good. Sound great.
Na
Hello there. Na 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 na. Welcome to the Jetty Jet Show. Sorry, guys. Man, what's wrong with you, Jet? Hella late.
Hello,
Yeah, hella
man.
late. Man, I'm leaving.
I just woke up. You can't
Steven,
leave.
I'm out of here, man. Hella late. Oh, what
Yeah, it's
happened?
your fault.
Oh shit. I heard feedback from myself and I was like, where the hell is. Oh shoot, I'm getting myself three times. There it is.
Turn off
There
your
it is.
feedback.
Huh? I know. Gotta press
Right.
pause. Hey guys, welcome everybody. I didn't drink too much. I didn't drink enough. I gotta drink a little bit. But today we have a special guest. Joining me is my best friend, Steven. Give it up for Steven. We need the claps. Cheers.
Hello, hello, hello,
Steven, man,
greetings from
what?
the Philippines.
How you doing today? How you doing today, brother?
I'm good. Honestly, I just woke up a little while ago because we had a late night. It was the girlfriend's birthday, so I took her out. You
You
know
cannot miss
how
that.
it is.
Oh, the girlfriend's birthday. Wow, that brings us right back onto our next subject.
Yes, yes.
Because we've had plenty
Yes.
of subjects in the past 2 seconds. We'll be talking today about. It's a special show. We're not going to be doing. Well, I am going to be drawing you guys. Don't get me wrong. I will be drawing for you. But today we're going to be talking about relationships, because this has got to be kind of a non-artist friendly type of show. Steven is an artist, but he's a different kind of artist. He's actually a singer, actor, celebrity in the Philippines. He does all kinds of things. He's a jack of all trades in the entertainment business. Why don't you tell us how did you get started in this world of fame? Because people might be wondering. And who are you? Who are you? Steven Silva? Who is this guy?
Oh shoot.
Maybe
Oh, you
we should
can't
start.
post links in the chat.
Oh no, you can't. But maybe we can
Okay.
start with where you started off in the Starstruck TV show 5. You
Okay.
were the winner there.
All right, all right. Well, yeah, me and Jet are both artists in our respective fields. Jet is, of course, illustrator. He does a lot of animation drawings. I, on the other hand, I was more of a. I actually joined the culinary arts field, so that's how me and Jed got to live together. We've been best friends since high school, but after high school, we both kind of did our own thing. We went to college. We still hung out, but then Jed went off to art school, and I was in Sacramento, still trying to figure out what I wanted to do. And then Jed gave me the idea. He's like, "Hey, man, you like to cook? Why don't you come out to San Francisco?" Go to culinary school,
I was just trying to get you to come live with me, that's all.
and
But
oh
yeah.
that too. So I actually took his advice. I went out there. I went to one of the culinary schools and I took a tour, and I ended up going to culinary school for like 2 years. We lived together. It was fun. It was really fun. Me, Jed, and our two other friends, and we were living together for 2 years in the Bay Area. And then after I finished my course in culinary, I had to pursue an internship. So I decided to go to my mom's hometown in the Philippines, which is Davao City. So I was working at a hotel, and what is it? Right after I finished my internship, there was an audition for Starstruck, which is kind of like the Filipino version of American Idol. So I ended up joining, and I ended up winning the show. So right now, I'm still working for the TV network that I auditioned for. Yeah, and I do stuff like I sing, I dance, I act. So that's how I got where I am now.
5 years later, he's on the Jetty Jet show. Yep, that's pretty
Yeah, oh
much
shoot.
it. It's been a crazy journey. Been a crazy, crazy journey. I remember when he was on the show. It's just the weirdest feeling to see your best friend on TV and then like go through all the rounds. Oh shoot, hold on. Can you guys hear me? I think Steven just disappeared. But anyways, yeah, he went on the show, like beat out like 80,000 contestants in the Philippines and worldwide. Everybody auditioned from everywhere, and then he ended up winning. He won first place. And then, yeah. So now he does stuff in the Philippines. But what am I going to be doing with this drawing that we have? This is a drawing that I did for a song that we did. We collaborated. Here. Whoa, turn on your input. Wait, no. My volume might be up. Yeah, you're good. Don't worry about input. That's okay. My volume. Yeah, my thing turned way up. But we did a song on his channel, and you guys can go check it out. It's in the link, his channel, and I used this kind of drawing to process video, so for the background of the song. And today I'm going to be drawing this same drawing, but it's going to be more anime, even more anime, because right now it's more illustration than it is anime. And that's supposed to be Steven on the left and me on the right. I'm like hot as fire, and Steven's like cool as ice, kind of thing.
Decide to color us red and blue.
The color, if you look at
that. I was wondering about that.
Yeah, I'm gonna show you. The color was originally cool looking. There we go. So these are the pictures that I use for reference. That's me and that's you. See, if you look at the tones. Everything's pretty red on mine. My hair, my skin, even the lighting. And yours is more indoors. So that gives it off like a cooler type of color. Oh, let's do a little shout out to the folks. Who we have out today?
Okay.
Who we got?
Let's see. Looking down the chat list, we got our usual suspect. We have I can never say his name right. Javoian.
Yeah, usual suspects. Bohemian
Assin is up in here.
He's guilty.
We got Boner, Monkey, Milk. He said, my sister got fourth in a cooking competition. Hey, that's great. When I was in school, I joined a pizza cooking competition. We didn't place at all, but we got free pizza.
And I got free pizza. Came home with like 20 yeah. different types of pizzas. It was crazy. They were like small little squares, about. Though. Oh, it was so good. That was the one thing I loved about you. You
got the roommates. Always got free food.
Got like free sushi, free pizza, free candy and sweets. Not candy, but bakery, baked stuff. It was amazing. Oh yeah, go down the list.
We got Fire. Who else we got? We got Fire putting his hands up. He said, "Hey, what's up?"
What's up, Fire? All right, so I'm gonna draw.
Steven would be PTH for Steven. Steven, I'm proud of you. Hey, man, thanks a lot. It's been a long road, but you know, we all here now.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, I'm going to do girl versions of us, too.
Double
so,
man. He's waving. He says hello with his pink hand.
Steven, you can hear me?
We got the Orca 333 saying, hey.
Testing. Steven, you hear me? Steven. We got technical difficulties. Steven got cut off again. But guys, let me know if you guys can still hear me. I'm going to draw the picture in a more anime style, this guy here, these guys here. And then I'm also going to do us in girl form. That'd be kind of cool. Kind of weird, but kind of cool. All right, so let's see. Let's try to make it more anime. Let's try to capture the look and feel of these guys. Okay. As soon as Steven gets back, we'll continue on with the questions, because we're going to be doing, because we were sitting down and we're just talking about how all the relationships that we've been through and like some of the issues that we've experienced in the past and some of the things we just wish would be, or the things that we've learned, a lot of stuff. Steven, you there? Steven, man.
I'm here.
Oh, you there? There.
I'm here.
All right. So, yeah. What's the first topic we got? And this is a short show, so we'll be going on for like probably an hour and a half. You there? Steven, you not there. You keep cutting off. You keep cutting off, boy. Yeah, I'm drawing Steven. Seems like he's got a longer kind of head than this. He's got more of a flat forehead. Yep. He gone. He'll be back. I hope. Kind of hard because Steven's in the Philippines. We'll see where the show goes. Oh, look at you guys, it's coming. The Jetty Jam musical. Okay, hold on, let's go to the quickness. Come meh. We got meh. Double meh. Meh. Double meh. I like that name. Meh double meh. We got Rekt. Rekt M90. We have Ultraless. Lari Nurmi. So we have Solaris. And we have Just in case you there. Good to have you on the show, buddy. Good to have all you guys on the show. It's been a while. And Steven's back. Dance with Shiny. Oh, I like Shiny. Shiny's cool. Yeah. A K-pop group. Bone and Monkey Milk. Some of these names are just so inappropriate, but I'll say it anyway. Because it's the Jetty Jet Show. Steven, you there? I see your face, dude. You're laying in bed. Oh. So.
Yeah, man, I kicked off.
You good now?
I'm good now.
Awesome.
My internet was like, nah. It was not having it.
It was like... It was like, nah.
But I'm back in here.
All right, so yeah, let's kick it off with the first question. I mean, first, we'll be taking questions, but we're going to do some, what's the word? Topics. We got some topics on hand. So what's the first topic, Steven? Unless you're going to leave again.
No, I'm here. Okay. I'm here. Well, okay. Well, like I said earlier, what is it? Somebody pointed out the name of this stream is Paintbrushes and Heartstrings. So while Jet's doing his thing with the art, you know, we thought we might talk about relationships and love life.
Yeah.
Talk so about love. We had some speaking points that we wanted to talk about. Some things that we've both experienced or experienced one way or another. I don't know if any of you have ever been in a relationship with someone, strictly friendship, and that person puts an ultimatum on you. Because this has happened to me multiple times. let's just say, Jen knows these people. It happened during high school. I had this one friend, really good friends. And let's just call her... let's just call her Desiree.
Desiree.
Yeah, okay. That's not her first name. That's not her real name, but let's just call her Desiree. So Desiree and I are good friends. We're always hanging out after school, during school. And then one day, she gives me an ultimatum. You know what she tells me? She says, Steven, I like you, but I don't think we can be friends unless we're boyfriend and girlfriend. And then I'm just sitting there like, what? What? Because this whole time I thought we were just friends. You know, I thought everything was going cool. We were cool. Hanging out all the time.
Platonic. That's what they call it. Platonic, man. You don't need to.
Yeah, platonic. Exactly.
Sorry.
She pulled that card and she said, you know what? I don't think we can be friends unless we're boyfriend and girlfriend. What do you think about that?
Oh, no, Steven.
Yeah, I told Desiree, I was like, I told her, right. I think we're just good as, like, friends. I don't see you like that.
Yeah.
And then, you know what happened?
Mm. Oh, snap. What a cliffhanger. This is this is the worst ever.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. Okay, you're here. You're back.
Oh, we got a first timer here. Allie.
Hold on, Steven. I got a plan, Steven. I'm going to invite you over here instead. I'm gonna see, maybe my connection is screwing it up. Wait, no, I can't. I can't switch it now.
No, I think it's my connection.
No, I was going to say, I was going to switch over to my laptop. But yeah, okay, what happened?
So you said, let's see. We got some questions here.
Oh, no, Steven. No, finish your story. Steve.
No,
you told her that you're friends, and then what happened? Do you guys end up being friends or no?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Well, after that, she ended up not talking to me for, like, months. Like, she would literally ignore me. And Jet knows this person. We would be in high school. Me and Jet always hanging out with Gabbert. We have our little clique. And she's actually friends with Jet. So she would come by, and she would talk to Jet, and she wouldn't mind me at all. Like, she wouldn't even notice I was there.
Oh.
So she...
Mm-hmm. So she would, all the juicy stuff. So bad. Hold on a sec. Let me think. I think she was hot.
She's okay.
Oh, shoot. Steven, you got cut off. You can repeat that?
You know, like, she wasn't hot.
Okay.
But then the thing is, like, that was hard. It's because the way I...
What? Hold on. Thinking about doing this.
What's going on?
Stream.
RecTM90 says friends with benefits.
No.
Well, that really didn't cross my mind. I was like 15 at the time.
Yeah.
I was like 15 or 14. I was like a second. I was like sophomore, or junior in high school.
No.
But that would have been. Would have been something to think about. Just passed my mind.
That would have been okay. So yeah, what I thought about this whole situation. Let's jump
someone,
into.
Someone commented. They said Jet was next in line.
I don't even know who it is. I'm not sure which one it was. But let's just tell the next story, and then because there was like two or three other occasions where this happened. It's just a curse for you. Not so much for me. And it happened over and over. And my response basically is if this is like a girl thing or something, I have some advice for the girls. Because I feel like
No, I just think the thing that we were talking about when we started talking about this, when I was telling you about this, is basically it just doesn't seem fair. And it's kind of like a battle to make them. It's kind of like you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't.
Yeah.
Because say, like, I say yes to her. I say yes, okay, let's be boyfriend, girlfriend. Yeah, I'm giving her what she wants. But at the same time, it's kind of silly because I'm just kind of giving in. Like, I basically, she put a gun to my head.
What are you gonna do? Like, it's not natural at all. It's just like, where did this come from? We never got romantic. So like, how did this all of a sudden happen? And now I'm supposed to say yes.
Everyone in the chat room though, they have a different idea.
Yeah.
Everyone's saying fuck buddies, friends with benefits, bow chicka bow wow. If she didn't notice you, you simply forgot to spray yourself with Axe. Dude, I think this was like 9 or 10 years ago. I don't even think Axe existed at the time.
Yeah. It might have actually.
But, yeah.
But whatever.
I don't remember. I don't think I had any Axe.
Why don't you move on to the next story? What's another situation where this happened?
Okay, well, let's see. Ultimatums, Nina Nerdface says, ultimatums are usually bad. Like, if a relationship results in one, it's usually a good sign that it's a bad relationship. Exactly. And Boner Monkey Milk says, go with your gut, which is exactly what I did. So I told her no. And what happened was, yeah, we ended up not being friends for about a couple months. A few months we didn't talk. I would try talking to her. She would literally just ignore me. Like, she would, I was basically just air.
How about but when you after guys a while, did start she, talking, guess, what happened?
Yeah. Well, then after a while, I think she started realizing it was kind of silly what she did. So we would start to talk, but honestly, our friendship was never the same. It was like we were never that close anymore as, like, to what we were before. Like, she gave me the ultimatum. So obviously, I think it was a bad move.
Yeah.
You know, just for both of us, like, bad move that she did that, and it was, like, a bad move that, like, we never got to talk again. Jepoian says, go with your boner.
Oh, okay, well, here's what I take from this. Yes. I just want to say...
You can never go wrong with that.
Steven, you hear me? I think we're off by a little bit.
I hear you.
Okay. So...
Yeah, I think it's lagging a little bit.
It's lagging. So, what I was going to say was, from this, I was just saying, like, okay, now... She lost him as a friend, you know what I mean? Like, Steven valued her as a friend. Like, she was a good friend, even to me. And it's funny because it happened to Steven about two other times in his life. And this is what prompted him. I was like, why don't we just do a show where we give some advice to people who may be going to this situation where they're in this, like, this emotion where they feel like they need to be with this person who's their friend, and they have no other way about it. I can't be with you unless we're together. Problem with that is, like, you lose the person as a friend. You can't have them as a friend because they're most likely going to say no if he's not pursuing you already. My advice is basically just sit back, chill, and relax. Relax. Take it easy. Just don't even worry about the relationship. Like, here's my position on relationships. I've had girlfriends in the past where, honestly, they weren't, like, all that hot, quote-unquote. You know what I mean? They were just, like, you know, average-looking people, like, just normal people. And the thing about it is, I valued their personality, like, a lot. And that's the reason why I fell in love with them, is because, like, they were just really nice and funny. Like, I hung out with them so much. They were my friends, and all of a sudden I started liking them. So then I started, you know, turning on the romance and pursuing it that way. But if you don't allow that point to happen, then it's never gonna happen. So in, like, Steven's situation, I feel like those girls had the opportunity, they had the chance. There were some girls in the past where you say if you gave it some more time, do you think you guys could have hit it off?
Me and this girl?
Yeah, like the girls, yeah. Like, if all of a sudden you guys are just, like, hanging out all the time and being friends, you know, anything can happen. That's what I'm basically saying.
Well, because the thing is, I don't think that would have happened, because, I mean, the way that I looked at her, it was completely just, like, friendship, you know what I mean? Like, there was no desire to take it to another level or anything like that.
Okay, well, that's Steven.
So, in my mind...
Go ahead.
You know, in my mind, it was already set.
That's going to be... That's permanent?
I don't know about permanent, but it's just at that time.
At that time. At that moment, that's what I mean. But in the future, you never know. You know what I mean? You might go on a few trips, and all of a sudden, something sparks. That's for me, anyway. Like, girls that I ended up hooking up with in the past were not the girls that I was, like, drawn to in the beginning. I really wasn't. Like, I wasn't attracted to them at all. But it was because of the time that we shared. It's just because we were friends and hanging out. All of a sudden, I'm like, what? I can't believe it. I like this girl. You know what I mean? And, you know, I would be like...
Yes.
Yeah, so...
But just, like, it's hard. Like, Javoyan says, maybe she just doesn't know how to ask someone out without using ultimatums. Well... Mm. I mean, using an ultimatum, like I said, it just doesn't seem fair, because basically you're just telling someone, you know what, if we're not going to be an item, we shouldn't be friends. Like, it's like, damn, okay, what happened to the friendship we just had? It kind of just throws it in, the trash if that person doesn't see you the same way. Because I guess, well, I remember you were saying that an ultimatum could be a good thing if maybe like the person, like one of them was kind of shy or whatever and didn't want to speak up.
Yeah.
But then as soon as they say that, it's like, okay, you know what? That's what I've been thinking too. But I'd like to think that's pretty rare. Okay, we got some other comments here.
Okay.
Boogie Monster 89. Boogie Monster. I think you sound familiar. He or she says, should have gave her a banana and then flung poo at her. They've shared food items very often, but I don't know if there's a poop at her. She might
Boogie
not
Monster,
like that.
Get back in your cage. You sound like a monkey.
And then we got Black Wings 03 says, you know, I was never friends with a girl I wasn't attracted to. Yeah. So if I wasn't attracted to her, I'd tell her to take a hike. Oh, okay. So all your friends must be very attractive. Or you are attracted to them. That seems kind of hard. That's kind of a hard screening system. Like you don't make friends with people you don't find yourself like having a future relationship with. But hey, to each his own. And then we got Ali Raspberry. As a person who was in the side of the rejected friend, I'd actually like to keep a friendship with my crush. But when I told her, it made things weird. Yes, that is hard. And that's actually another topic that we have for later or in a little bit, is the magical friend zone.
Oh, friend zone. Don't put me in the friend zone.
Not the friend zone. I don't like the friend zone. I don't want to touch you, but I am in the friend zone.
Friend zone. Put me in
the
zone.
I want to be your lover, but you put me in a zone. I'm only a friend, baby.
Sound like one of those 70s.
Oh, shoot. I know, it sounds like a 70s porn song. Alright, okay. We got a bunch of we got a lot of comments. Hello to everybody, by the way. It's awesome.
Let's
everybody's watching. I hope you guys are enjoying.
Yeah.
Anyway, we got some more comments.
Okay, let's go to comments.
See what their input is. RecTM90 says, sad face, never had a relationship, but had a few one night stands, though. Well, that's definitely something. That's something different.
Yeah, something different.
We'll talk about that later. And then we got Boner Monkey Milk says, personality is greater than physical attraction.
You know what I'm saying?
That is very, very true.
You know, here's one thing we can talk about. Here's what I'm talking about. Like, you ever notice when a hot girl turns you down and she all of a sudden you find out that she's a bitch? Like, straight up, just bitchy attitude, just the mean person? They turn into the ugliest people you ever meet. Like, every feature about them just... all of a sudden, it's like, you're disgusting. Like, I don't care about you, girl. Tripping.
What is that? Like, people used to have a crush on?
No, I'm saying people who are hot. You know what I mean? And so, like, beauty is like, if your personality can make or break a person, you know what I mean? Like, a person with a bad personality can all of a sudden become ugly, you know what I mean? A person with a good personality becomes so much beautiful in your eye. And that's the thing about love, is that love is blind to an extent. Sometimes.
Yeah. I feel you on that. The one thing about that is, like, physicality and, like, looks, they will fade. They don't last forever. But the type of person you are, that's something that should stay, you know, for the rest of your life.
True.
Yeah, okay, we got another comment. Twall Up, he says, the best way to go into a relationship is to let it happen naturally. If it's going to happen, it will happen.
There we go! That's
yes,
exactly
that is very
what I'm
true.
To say. That's what I'm trying to say.
If but, of course, happen. That's in a perfect world. That's in a perfect world, man. Relationships don't always happen naturally.
Yeah.
But that is true. Hopefully, they, you know...
No, what I think he's
naturally.
Trying to say is, it's like if
but
it's
that's where
happen,
these ultimatums come in, because that's where something where it doesn't happen naturally.
Yeah.
One person thinks the other, while the other...
Oh, there he goes. That's why he was ignoring me. See, Steven? You ignoring me, you're gonna get booted. You see? I didn't boot him. I think... He's having technical difficulties again. But there we go. I think I'm gonna do the lines first for the girl version. Otherwise, I don't think I'm gonna have enough time. That way, we'll have.
Going on the drawings yet.
Hey, what's up? What's up, robot man?
Let's not forget one of the other main reasons why we're all here.
Oh, what? What happened? What happened now? Steven. Shoot-a-bang. Shoot-a-bang, shoot-a-bang. We should call Steven Shoot-a-bang. Because his last name is Silva. And so in Japanese class we had, they would call him Shiruba. But the Koreans... Oh, Steven, you got music going. You got music going. Oh, dear.
Oh, shoot. That's my dad's phone. He's getting texts. Okay. He's getting texts on his phone.
Okay.
I'm sleeping right now on the bunk bed.
So I was saying, your name, man, Shiruba. Anyway, Shiruba, we'll talk about it later.
Okay.
So, what's the next topic?
Well, Boner Monkey Milk, I think, was the one that talked about it. He just says right now, you know, sometimes you need to give up on chasing people when you are in the friend zone. So, the friend zone. I'm wondering, I'm going to ask this question to everybody out there in the chat. Has anyone out there ever been zoned? And, or, have you ever friend zoned somebody? And I'm wondering why. So I'm guessing for me, the whole ultimatum thing that happened, because, yeah, I probably put her in the friend zone. I basically put her in this group of people that was like, you know, she's a friend, that's it, nothing else can happen. And I don't know, what do you think, Jed? Do you think if the friend zone is a bad or a good thing?
I think it's a great thing, man. Friends, more friends, the better, man. Shoot. Can't just hang out. Like, come on. Like what? What is it? Look, I understand one thing. For one thing, if all of a sudden you put the moves on the person and then you turn off the emotion, I get that. Because, like, all of a sudden you built this kind of expectation. It's like being romantic. It seems like something can happen between the two. If that's the case, then putting the person in the friend zone after that, okay, I think that's pretty shitty. But if you were to be friend zoned after nothing, we're friends. It's like, man, that's kind of messed up.
Yeah,
it's
it becomes kind of hard. Yeah. Yeah, it becomes hard when they don't see it like that.
Yeah.
But okay, here we go. We got some comments. Nina Nerdface says, can we change the friend zone trend to be called the bro zone? You know, I'm actually all for that. I just don't know if the girls would like to be called bros. But hey, if they're fine with it, I'm fine with it. I like that. It sounds more approachable. Because if you're a friend zone, you don't know. Maybe you're a danger friend, like a danger stranger or something. But then, yeah.
Stranger danger!
Yeah, remember that? Stranger danger. But yeah, bro zone sounds a little more better. Javoyan says, I friend zoned one girl because she was ugly. Yes, one of the many reasons why people get friend zoned because of ugliness.
That's fucked up.
Oh, we got wreck team. Hey, it's true, man. It's
because of ugliness, world. how about just their preference in looks, you know? Because I like to believe
that
no one's really ugly.
That's why I friend zoned Desiree. Honestly, I mean, I just wasn't attracted to her.
There you go.
That's why I friend zoned her. But okay, RecTM90 says, you know, I've been friend zoned. I was 8 years. I even tried to pay her money later. I was very.
Whoop! Steven! He turned into a girl, and I can't figure out a hairstyle. Doesn't look like a girl to me. Maybe the outfit's tripping me out. Get out of here, our outfit. Sorry, guys. I am not looking at the comments. As soon as Steven gets back on, we'll get back on the comments. Word. But if it takes them too long, I'll get on the comments. Don't worry. There you are. What it be?
I'm here.
What it be?
I'm here.
What it be? And I said, what it do?
Can you hear me, guys?
I can hear you. I just repeated myself 3 times, Steven. That's all I did.
Oh, can you guys hear me now?
Yeah, I hear you.
Sorry, my connection be messing up sometimes. Oh, no. People are saying, Steven, come back, please, senpai. Steven, we need you. I'm back. Okay. We got a long comment here. Yeah, Javon, I saw you said ugly personality. But here we go. Graham Goodall Smith says, everyone has been friend-zoned because one person isn't for everyone. I friend-zone people that are giving, they're going to be way more trouble as anything more. Well, I think it happens. I mean, sometimes, yeah, I think it's just like compatibility. Like, not everybody's compatible with everyone. Marky Adams says, well, I...
Oh, Marky Adam Adamson! Due to high volume comment loading disabled, click here to continue loading comments. Marky Adam says,
thoughts on this.
Steven, you got cut off for like another couple seconds, dude.
Boogie, care to expand on the topic?
This is the craziest circus show ever.
Yeah, I keep getting cut off.
You're hella delayed. But yeah. Is there any way maybe you can move downstairs or something? I don't know. Would that help? Yeah. Maybe not.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
I said, can you hear me? Alright. We got some more comments. Ooh. Guilherme Alves de Oliveira says, the friend zone is a good thing in my opinion. Once I date with a friend, and I...
Up. Alright, so I'm going to just talk about this friend zone thingy. Steven keeps getting cut off. So, like, when I'm in a friend zone, because here's the thing in my situation. Maybe it's just me. I don't know. Maybe I'm just a crazy person. But if a girl, like, in the past growing up, like, if she was friendly to me, all of a sudden I get attracted to that person. Like, I'm just attracted to friendly people. So, like, that's what happened. And if I was attracted to someone who wasn't, because of just friendliness or whatever, because we were just buddies, and I all of a sudden was attracted to that person, you know, just because of straight up looks, you know what? If I'm just their friend, that's fine. I get to be around that girl, you know what I mean? I get to be around that person, and I think that's fine. And I think the courtship or the time it takes for you guys to actually fall in love, you know, could be a while. They might not like automatically like you, but give it some time, like, I think it'll turn into something, and that's just how I see it. Give it some time. Don't rush it. And who knows? Maybe something else will happen. Maybe you might find someone else along the way, and you're like, you know what? I'm tired of waiting. I'm just going to move on. Which brings me to one of my experiences in the past. In one of my relationships, I was the side guy, okay? I was the side dude. And I was fine with that because the girl had a boyfriend, you know? And...
Hey!
I was about to tell... I was about to tell him a story of mine.
Oh, my bad, sorry. You're getting disconnected.
It's cool. Cool. What's the next topic? Because I'm about to jump into a story if you don't want to. Because we got it. Okay. So.
Tell your story.
Story was with, we'll call her, what's her name? Her name's going to be We'll call her...
Urethra.
No. Okay, fine, Urethra. So Urethra... Urethra... dang. This doesn't sound right. Alright, so... I was hoping to be with Urethra for the longest time, and what happened was she had a boyfriend, and then it was just like we were getting pretty close, but I can't really put moves on a person with a boyfriend too much, you know, otherwise it's just wrong. So I waited and waited and waited, but what ended up happening was her best friend was my friend, and because she was always doing stuff, I ended up, you know, hanging out with her best friend. Just, you know, like, where's Urethra? Let's go hang out, because Urethra, I want to be with Urethra, you know? And...
Urethra.
Yeah. So that's what happened. I was around her so much, we started just, like, hanging out, like exclusively. And then we just watched movies and stuff. And honestly, she wasn't the most attractive person out there. That's the honest truth. But because I was just like hanging out with her so much, all of a sudden started to have feelings, and then we hit it off and became a couple. But then later on, we broke it off because they felt like it was kind of a shitty kind of situation to be for her to kind of have me as a side guy and then go with the best friend kind of thing. It just wasn't a good feeling for the girl that I ended up going with the girl I ended up with, her best friend. They probably talked it out and were like, that's not cool. But the problem was, you already have a boyfriend. Why is it a problem? Like, what the... How could it be a problem? I even said, you know, like, I understand, like, we are kind of, you know, talking and stuff, but I'm kind of tired of waiting. I waited for, like, I think 6 months or something like that. And, yeah, anyways.
That's a long time.
And I was just like, you know what? I'm tired. I don't want to be single. I'm gonna go with this girl. And I liked her. But then we broke up because of them. But anyways, that's what happened.
All right, Urethra.
Okay. No, not all right. Urethra kind of just messed it all up. But yeah.
Well, fuck for Urethra.
Okay. Hold on. So what's the next topic, Steven? Let's do it, because this show is going to be going on for just about an hour and a half. And we got another hour left.
Well, let's see. We talked about friend zone. We talked about ultimatums. The next thing that you actually brought this one up. Breakups. Breakups can be good for you.
Breakups can be a good thing.
Breakups can be good for you.
I truly believe in that. What do you think about breakups before you get cut off? You sound good right now.
They're hard, man. It's a double-edged sword. It's like, gotta feel pain to get educated, you know, to learn better, mm-hmm. to experience. So, I mean, I've been through a few. They suck at first. It's weird. It kind of feels like, you know, things will never be better. Things will just be like basically shit. Like, you'll never have a chance again to like do anything or whatever. But then, you know, you start to come to realize that it's just part of the game. Part of the learning process.
There's a lot to take away when you break up with somebody. It's a lot to take away because you kind of reflect on yourself for days, especially if you're on the losing end or the side that's been broken up with, right? You've been there, Steven, right? That's what we're talking about. Where they break up with you. You've been on that side, right?
Oh, yeah. I've been on both sides. Never easy.
So, you got to take it as a learning process, and that's what I kind of look at it as. And you have a lot of time to reflect on kind of the errors you made. You know, you just think about everything and how you would do things differently. Because sometimes you might get too comfortable, especially if it's your like one of your first relationships. After a while, you might get comfortable and you just take things for granted. And I think that's one of the biggest reasons why people break up or why relationships go wrong is because they take it for granted, you know? If you, for example, like, just meet someone, you're constantly trying to, like, swoon the girl, trying to be romantic and win the girl's heart. So it's always exciting every single day. But then when you're with that person for a while, you just kind of think that they're always going to be there. So you just kind of forget about them.
Yeah, start to take things for granted.
Yeah, so another thing is, a really big important thing is that when you break up with the person, because I've been on the side where I had to speak with the person who's, like, I had, like, three friends, close friends, in a row where their relationship, they break up with their significant other. And I was the comforting person, you know, just there for them and talking to them. And I keep telling them the same thing. It's like, you're going to be grateful that the person left you in the end. You're going to be grateful. Because you're going to move on to something else in your life, and you're just going to be like, dang, I could have been stuck with that other person. Dang. The person you end up with in the future could be the person you want to be with for the rest of your life. And you'll be like, thank you for leaving me. But, what?
Exactly.
Yeah, what do you have to say about all that craziness? What kind of hair should I give?
No, I mean, what? What kind of hair you should give who?
This girl.
I think you should give her a ponytail.
Ponytail.
Put her hair up in a bun. Yeah, put it up in a bun. But yeah, I saw a good comment here by Twallop. Twallop says, "Has anyone ever been through a silent breakup where the person just starts avoiding you?" I don't think I've ever been through that. What about you, Jed?
Silent? No, I haven't. Where the person just starts avoiding. Yeah, that's kind of messed up.
That's kind of bad. That's kind of, like, disrespectful, I think.
Yeah.
You spend all that time with someone, and then, like, you instead of, like, telling them you want to break up, you just kind of, like, just, like, let them assume. Yeah. Or just kind of just leave them hanging. I think that's the worst.
Yeah.
But, Javoyan has a question. I have a question for Jet. Okay. Jet, has any girl you've been with hated your drawings or wanted you to stop drawing or draw less often?
No, not really. I don't think so. That was never an issue. Kind of one of those things. I don't know. It's just, I draw. No one really complains about me drawing. Now get it together. Stop trying.
Yeah, that would be hard.
Oh, yeah.
It would be hard.
If I had to make a decision between drawing and the girl, sorry, girl, I've been with drawing for like 25 years now. You gotta go. Too long.
Yeah, that would be hard. So then that's kind of like another ultimatum, kind of like someone you get with and then you find out that they don't like what you like doing, which is maybe be like your path, and they're like,
yeah.
You know what? You better choose me over your passion.
You better choose me.
You know why that's hard?
Why?
I think the main reason why that's hard is because whatever that is that you take passion in, it kind of like makes up who you are as a person.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's like one of those things. It's like you can't accept a person for who they are. It's like, why be with them? You're the one picking, right? I mean, if the person's a football player, like, know that they're a football player before you want to be with them. You know what? I don't like that you play football. Like, you either be with me or play football.
Stop playing football. Like, hey, man, stop playing football.
Doesn't work like that.
Stop playing football. Dang, I can't even decide on the hairs.
Graham Goodall Smith says, I had a girl tell me I needed to stop doing stand-up comedy, cancel my festival show, and focus on uni. Oh, no. Yeah, see, that's hard, like, especially if it's something you really love doing. A girl can't just tell you to stop. Well, anyone, a girl like that can't just be like, you know, you need to stop doing that. Because why? Because that's something you love doing?
She wants you to focus on what now? Focus on who?
Oh, she wanted on school, university.
Focus on who? Oh, yeah. Okay. Go on, man.
Oh, you got some comments.
Yeah.
You got some comments for the drawing. Boner Monkey Milk says, Jet, you need to give her bigger boobs. Javorian says, Jet, I think lipstick and breasts will be cool.
Oh. Okay.
Faya says, haha, friend zone art.
There, I did boobs. You're done? You happy? The boobs are there. It's kind of weird. I transformed us into girls, if you notice. Trying to do it faster, man. This is going too slow. So I could color these guys.
Ooh, okay. I think Zeta Wolf said it correctly. Oh, he has a good comment. He says, you know, I barely accepted myself as an artist. Now, if someone were to question that, I might have to either rethink my life, I would punch them in the face. That's a good point. I mean, because, like, I mean, geez, like, you are on Netflix. Makes you question that or try to change that, then maybe they should just find someone else or be friends or be in a relationship with someone else. So what's the point? Oh, here we go. We got a question for you, Jet.
Yeah.
This is from Nina Nerdface. She says, question for Jet.
Yeah, what's
Have
up,
you ever girl? Had a girl try to use you for your talents because she wanted you as a way to lift herself up?
No. I don't deal with that. That's the thing. I have the right to choose who I be with.
Javillion says she wanted free commissions. Exactly.
All day, every day, just free commissions. That's why I want to be with this guy. It's just I just want drawings. That would be awesome if it worked that way. Look, girl, I can draw. I can draw. You want to be with me? Get away from me, creep.
Exactly.
He's kind of just, yeah, not working. You just love me for my drawing?
Rec TM says, you know, to be honest, I haven't been in a relationship, but for me, what scares me is that a relationship can be a dream killer, at least if it becomes a serious one. Therefore, I stay ONS. I stay with one-night stands. It can be awkwardly fun. Hey, whatever floats your boat, man. But I wouldn't say all relationships are dream killers. If anything, a good relationship should be something that supports your dreams.
Yeah.
You know, builds it up.
Absolutely.
Javoyan says, you know, I'm too scared to ask out girls. I'm afraid of rejection.
A lot of people are, man.
Oh, man. All I gotta say to that is, you know, you gotta risk to win.
That's right.
You can't win if you don't gamble.
Damn.
You can't win if you don't play.
Nope. You're never gonna win if you don't play. Sir.
Yeah, I mean, rejection does suck, but you know what? Even if you get rejected, I mean, you're basically back to where you started. I mean, you have nothing really to lose.
Yeah.
Yeah, Graham says, you know, it's all about how you ask and how you take it. But I don't think there's anything wrong with being shy. Faya has the best pickup line. He says, hey, girl, I'm gonna draw you.
Hey, girl. I'm going to draw you. Well, I've been in a relationship for the past 10 years, so it's kind of like, for me, I've been out of the game for a little bit. For a little bit, you know what I mean? But we did take a break for a while because we were just trying to figure out who we are, which was the best thing ever. But during that time, I was back in the game for a minute, you know, trying out my skills, and it was tough. I was like, all of a sudden, because when you're in a relationship, it's really, it, it makes you really confident. I think that's a good topic. when you're in a relationship, you feel like you can talk to anybody, and you're just confident because, you know, I'm not trying to be with anyone. But, like, once you're single again, it's like, crap. I'm scared again. What the hell? I can't even tell that girl she's pretty. What the hell? I used to tell all the girls they're pretty. Anyways. Yeah. Stupid.
I like how everyone's giving each other advice. Graham just says, hey, don't ask will you go out with me. Ask, hey, I've been wanting to go late night bowling, ice skating, whatever for a while, and I need
there
a partner.
You, go.
You want to come? Yeah, exactly.
That's what's up. Do you have another topic?
No, I'm checking out the chat with questions. Oh, we got another question from Blarg Cake. He says, when you draw from imagination, do you project what you envision in your mind onto the paper? How does that work for you, Jet, when you draw from imagination?
That's sometimes. Sometimes. If I'm given, like, a guide, like, or an emotion. Say, for example, if there's an emotion involved, there usually will be an image, like, what kind of feeling I'm trying to capture, you know. If it's a gloomy feeling or a happy feeling, there's usually a kind of a visual feeling that comes with it, or an image. And if it's something like this, I am just discovering it as I go. I don't know. I don't see anything. I don't see anything except what's in front of me. So it's like one thing after another. Just that, yeah. That's all there is to it. That's all there is to it to do it. That's what you gotta do. You do the good one. Okay? So, yeah.
Do the dancing.
Do the dancing. Every day, go to schools to be the good boys.
Oh, see. What is it? Zeta Wolf says, Steven, you have to throw it out there. Because you only lose a race that you don't enter. And that's the main thing. You know, if you don't ask someone out, or if you don't, like, you know, say how you're feeling, you're just going to be stuck in square one. I mean, you're not going to... You're not gonna get anywhere. I don't know. I think, you know, it's kind of sad. I mean, you just don't want to leave things a chance.
Yeah.
She says no. She says no. Then you move on to the next girl. She says yes. Then there you go.
Yeah.
Okay. Zeta Wolf also has a question for you, Jay. He says, "How long did it take your line work to develop?"
How long did it take for me? Line work for like professionally, I'd say about 10 years, but it's a constant work in progress. Constantly working, because it's never good enough. Never, ever, ever, ever good enough. Yeah. So let's tell them what we're doing for the new people. We're actually just talking about relationships while I draw simple drawings. From this drawing that I did. If you guys want to see the process to this video, it's on Steven's channel, and that's in the description. We actually sing in this video. That's right. We sing together. A little collab. Finally, we did it, and it's on his channel. And you can see the process picture to this. Yeah. We used to sing all the time, but we never really recorded. We would record halfway, and we wouldn't finish it, and that's like most of the things. But... anyways, there's a process video for this, and today I'm just doing little sketches, trying to make it more anime-ish, because I feel like this one may be a little too difficult. And then I'm going to do this in a girl version as well. Okay? Cool. All right, continuing on.
Let's see. But yeah, I think Graham, he's been giving some good advice. Another thing, I mean, he says, you know, if you ask and she says no, what, people are going to make fun of you for being confident? Exactly. There's nothing wrong with that. I mean,
what is
it? Like Justin Bieber says, ain't nothing more sexy than ambition. Like take Justin. A shot and miss it. Ain't nothing more sexy than ambition. Ambition.
Uh-huh.
Ambition. Filipino accent popped out. Ambition. And then Nina Nerfa says, if you're worried about gossip in high school, you know, you're wasting energy you can be spending on pursuing your dreams. It's true. People are always going to talk. Dear God, yes. I mean, knowing just from my side of things, being in the showbiz world, people always have something to say, and it's really annoying. So, people all have their opinions.
I think that's a cool segue into that topic. I remember I was mentioning it. How about relationships in the entertainment or being a celebrity? How do you handle relationships? Okay. Like, how has it been for you? And
definitely.
And what kind of things did you say?
Let's say hello real quick. Joe Hernandez, he just came in late. He says, "Who's the guys with Jet?" Yeah. Zeta Wolf and Javoin are right. My name is Steven. I'm one of Jet's friends.
That's so Steven right
Joe.
There.
Welcome.
That's the guy sitting with me talking.
Yeah,
and
okay.
That's me.
Oh, yeah. So, just going back to what they were talking about, how people will always talk. People will always talk. They always have their opinion. You know, sometimes at the end of the day, you just have to decipher who you want to listen to and who's important. Because those are the people, you know, you should really care about, because a lot of people are just going to say shit. And just coming from my point of view, being in the showbiz world, I was actually dating another person in the business, like another celebrity. And it's just hard, because it's easy to get caught up with what everyone's telling you, because, like, people would be telling me, like, oh, you know what, you should just give up on her, you should, you know, just break up with her, she's not good for you, she's ugly, she's not right for you, she's going to take advantage of you. And these people don't even know us, like, they know nothing about us. So it's just really treacherous. You have to be careful, because, like, everyone's going to say something, even more so in our situation, being, like, in the position that we are, being in showbiz, like, you know, everyone thinks they know us. Everyone loves to talk. Everyone loves to gossip.
They love to say things, and we try to give you advice. Just, how's it like to keeping up with it, with the busy schedule, and you guys are both being celebrities and all?
Oh, it's hard, man. Because more often than not, it'd be like if I was busy, she'd be free. If she was busy, I'd be free. Like, a lot of times the schedules would really conflict.
If you guys ever want to see some of his production, you filmed what is it called? The Boston Kitchen Musical. I got that in the link below too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, did you put it in the link?
Yeah, it's in the.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Just to selflessly promote myself. You guys are familiar with the Kitchen Musical. It's kind of like Glee, but, like, set in the kitchen. Like, if you guys are fans of food or, like, cooking, if you guys are foodies, and if you like music, yeah, check the link in the description. The name of the show is called The Boston. It's the sequel of the Kitchen Musical. I think we're now airing in the States. We finished filming last year. It's a TV series. It's an 8-episode TV series. We finished filming it last year. And yeah, you can watch it. Jeff put the link in the description. All 8 episodes are on there, so you can just stream the episodes. I'm on there. I play the character named Sid. I'm the pastry chef. And yeah, you can check it out. I think we're going to be shooting the second season later this year.
If you guys want to see a good episode, was it number 3, the one with the cooking competition? I like that one.
Oh yeah, that's episode 4, I think. Episode 4. It's basically in the show, one of our chefs decides to put on a Iron Chef like competition during the show, and it basically puts the head chef against the sous chef, and it's pretty cool. I'm actually one of the assistants. I help out Noah, and yeah, I definitely would encourage you guys to check it out. It's a cool show. Really proud of that show. It's really a beautiful show. It was done really well. I mean, just like beautiful in the sense of like the cinematography. It's really, really done well. But yeah.
It's gonna be on cable.
Okay. Yeah, I think it's airing in the States right now. They said it's airing on Mix TV. I don't know what channel that is in the States.
No.
Nina Nerdface says, "Please tell me you teach people how to cook while doing elaborate musical numbers, because that would be amazing."
That would be amazing.
Well, I don't necessarily recommend you really cook while you do elaborate musical numbers, because that's really dangerous. It's amazing, but dangerous. You might not cook so well, like, you know, you don't, like, divert your attention.
Well, if it was done like, you know, in like a show way, like it wasn't like really cooking. They're just that's part of the show. You know, like a show.
Like that. And Javoyan says, cook an awesome meal, bring it to Crush, sing to her, and draw her while she's eating it. Equals confirmed girlfriend. That's how Steven would do it. Maybe I would do the cooking and singing, and then I think Jet would do the drawing. So, hey, if ever you need to, like, propose to someone or, like, ask a girl out, I can sing to her and cook to her, and Jet will draw. And yeah. You can just stand there and ask her while we're, after we're done.
Do that.
Yeah, we can help you out there. But yeah, definitely, if you guys want to check out the show, it's called The Boston Kitchen Musical. It's in the description. It's a pretty cool show. I didn't even know you put the link there.
Yeah, man. I got you. I put it in today. I just realized. I was like, oh, could put your show in there because we'll be mentioning it. Yes. But what else we got? Any more of those... topics we got, or any questions you guys have?
Okay, we got a question for you, Jet. When you color, how do you use colors that work? Or maybe I guess like how do you know what colors work for your drawing?
Colors are really difficult. That's probably the most difficult, even more than drawing. Well, it's probably the same as drawing. It's just another world, and colors usually depend on just what's around each other. So, depending on what you have on the canvas already, that will tell you what other colors will work with it. And that just depends on like knowing technical things like complementary colors and analogous colors and just what those terms are. And once you know those things, you just know what works. But there are lots of methods where you can use to understand color and learn it. There's one where you just use two colors, and you use those two colors to color everything pretty much black and white, but using color. So like a red and a lighter red, or like blue and a lighter blue, things like that. But one of the biggest, most important things about color is it's all about, for the most part that I've ever experienced, it's all about warms and colds. Warms and colds. Everything revolves around a warm and a cooler palette. Cold things get pushed back, warm things move forward. But if you wanted like a really gloomy feeling, a really dramatic, emotional, sad feeling, then everything would be blue, and maybe the bluest things could be pushed forward. Just depends on what the ratio is. What? But yeah, that's a big topic.
What?
Who what? Who what?
Yes.
Who what?
Dude.
Yeah.
You spelled your name wrong on Twitter. You didn't put the Jetty Jet Show. You put the Jetty Jet So.
Oh! The Jetty Jet So. That's my cow.
Oh, no. I love Jet. I love Jet to death. He's my...
he disappeared. He's gonna say something about my spelling. I know it. But yeah, sorry if I can't like really just get into detail about the color thing, but how do I know? Keep it simple. So you don't have to color too much. You can just stick with one or two colors and then slowly introduce colors in. And keeping things desaturated is a really good trick if you guys wanna just play around with a lot of colors at the same time, keeping things desaturated. I just hit Control U and I'm moving the saturation button back. And then when you start wanting to put more focus into things, just move up the saturation in those areas. Because one of the common issues with drawings is that they pop forward too much. They're too saturated. Too saturated. Yeah. But yeah, I think this is okay to stick with that. But she got a big old arm. Big. Big old hands. I tend to do that. Steven, you coming back? Sorry, man. I got you. I love you, too. I love you, too, man.
wherever you are. He's gone back into the ether. I'm sorry, I'm not paying attention too much to the conversation because I want to finish this, you guys. I can look up right now, but then the show is going to end in like 20 minutes. Okay, so thanks. The warm colors are so good. Getting all those shades. Zeta Wolf, thanks. Between the light beige and crimson is awesome. I'm pretty damn good with vector, but painting in Photoshop with the tablet is so bleeping hard color-wise. Wrecked me. Bonamonkey said, bye. See Graham. Bye, Graham. Bye, Graham. Graham. See ya. Peace. Dance with Shiny. Bye. Talking about names, you learned how to speak my name yet? I did. Guillermo Alves de Oliveira. I don't know. Sorry, dude. Okay, back with the vengeance. Back with the vengeance. All right. Color. What color for the hair? What color for the hair? Let's see. Oh, back.
Hey, sorry.
Good to have you.
Internet messing up.
It's all good. It's all good in the neighborhood. Sam? Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I hear you fine now.
Good.
Sorry, guys. I'm reading through the comments. Oh, I love it. It's awesome. We got Tremendous Rex says, hey, rad, first Jetty stream I've been able to catch.
Awesome.
Ali Raspberry, good, I just love you, how fluid the subject is on these streams are. Because the Jet Steven romance is on fleek. Maybe that, but maybe because we actually wrote down some things to write down. We took some notes. We're like, you know, we need to be prepared.
Yeah.
So we've been preparing for this for about a week or so. So we're glad you guys are enjoying. This is tight. We got more than 50 people that are watching right now. So hello, everybody. Thanks for watching.
Well, hello. Well, hello.
Okay. Dina Nerdface says, by the way, Jet, watching your and Cypress streams have really helped me as an artist, both with skill and confidence. So I wanted to say thank you a ton for posting your videos.
Oh. You're welcome. You're welcome. Glad I can help. Is that Mina?
That's Nina Nerdface.
You're welcome.
Yeah, she said that.
You're welcome, Nerdface. I love you. and I'll get into more tutorials later on. Just trying to do some shows, and I've been working, been really busy, but I got tons of art shows and tutorials. I'm going to break down some more crazy stuff for you guys. Promise, I promise.
Some people popping in. Kian Fox says hello. Alfaya, you said hello, but you've been here since the beginning.
People are like, who's a new guy?
Javoyan says, you know, I suck at color and drawing too, but my color is so much worse. Is color really that hard? I mean,
yeah.
Not hard.
Yes. So, like, okay, let me show you. Watch this.
What's like the hardest part about color?
It's probably just, I guess, picking it, picking your colors, and like keeping the saturation levels down. Okay, like a lot of times people just pick a color, and this is what it'll look like. That's my color for her hair. And then your eyes are just like bleeding because they're so powerful. This is the meaning of saturation. This is saturation, okay? If you turn on the saturation, that means there's less color present and more. It's more mixed up with more like grays and blacks with black. So we're pulling it back, see? It's becoming less saturated. And it just blends nicer with the background. And I just changed the color of her skin.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Javoyan also comments. He says, watching Jet's videos make me feel motivated. Keep drawing so I can get the good one. Oh,
he's going to get the good one.
Oh, we got another question for you, Jet. Boner Monkey Milk asks, yeah, has Jet ever been furious?
Steven, you know when all about that.
When has he not been furious?
I beat Steven whenever he comes visit.
Yeah, Jeffy wrestling me, he beat me up. But I don't know what you mean by furious. Like, furious like angry, furious like crazy.
Oh, shoot. Probably means like angry because they think that I might be always happy and fun loving and positive all the time.
Well, that's not true. I seen Jake get crazy. Jake always trying to beat people up.
What?
Jake's not a nice person sometimes. He's trying to beat people up.
I just try to beat people up. I mean, that's what I do. I walk around and try to beat them up. I'm sorry. It happens.
Don't try to meet him outside of YouTube. He's trying to beat you up. Just playing.
No, you ain't playing. This is the truth. I will beat you up.
This is the truth. This is real life right here.
You don't know what you get into.
Okay, well, let's bring it back to the Heartstrings part of the show. We have one more question, one more topic. And this is... topic is trust, or more specifically, trust issues. I ask you guys, how important is...
Whoa! How important is trust to you guys? Can you guys just answer that question? How important is trust? For me, you guys, trust is probably... Sure. I can't say the most important thing. I'd say it's one of the most... It's probably up there with the top five, top three, trust. Anyways... Yeah, go ahead, finish it up, Steven.
It's like trust is almost like...
Yeah.
It's almost like... What is it? That's like the number one thing. Man, if you don't trust somebody, how can you even be in a relationship or even like a friendship with someone?
Yeah.
That's hard, man. I mean, trust is almost like right up there with respect.
This isn't like...
If you don't
like,
trust someone, it's almost like you don't have respect for them.
This isn't like, you know, honey...
That's hard.
I'm gonna go to the club tonight and not talk to anybody, you know, and then you're like, you feel insecure, you know. That's not bad. I mean, not bad to feel a little too insecure about that. But we're talking about the trust where you're always constantly checking up on the person, wondering where they are when they have no history of like, doing anything wrong. That can be the reason why it pushes you guys away.
Exactly, like people like trying to check, like you said, like check up on you, like always trying to know where you're at, like what you're doing. And at the end of the day, you're your own person, you know. You need to live your life.
Yeah. And trust.
Wait a second. I'm just getting this now. Wait, the drawing that you're doing right now. Did you just make us into girls?
Yeah, dude. We're girls.
Is that us in girl form?
We're also boys, but we're also girls. I mean, because that's what people like to see. So.
Oh, what the hell? Which one am I? Do I have the blue hair or the brown hair? I'm just noticing now.
Which one do you think, man? Which one do you think?
I don't know.
Get it together, Grouch!
I'm guessing I'm the one with the darker hair.
Yes. Yes.
Do I have big boobs?
Yeah, you do. Hold on a second.
I just noticed now because Gavoyan said Steven looks more kawaii than Jed in the drawing.
Oh, shoot. Your hands are huge, though.
God, but anyway, let's get some questions. Anwar says, do you think making a color tutorial or have you thought about making a color tutorial or have you already have?
Oh, that's a good question. I absolutely will be making a color tutorial. It's going to be an extensive list, but I have to knock down a few things. I like to take them in order. Like, I like to do just a straight up... you know, forms and shapes, squares and stuff like that. And then I go into like just gesture, figures. And then we actually learn figure drawing. And then right now I'm in pretty much the figure drawing stage. I'd like to cover the full body, the eyes, the nose, the hair, all that stuff. Once all of that human anatomy stuff, I will move on to maybe color. Maybe color, because I think there's perspective too that goes in there. But yeah.
Twalip says the easiest way to learn color is to keep drawing from life, and you start to notice how desaturated most colors actually are. Is that true?
That is true. it's not the easiest way, because making sense of what is around us is sometimes hard.
Draw from life.
Yeah. Really hard.
Okay, oh, and then back to the topic. A lot of people, yeah, they agree, and a lot of people are agreeing. But by the way, Zeta Wolf says, he says, I'll fight you, Jet, one-on-one.
Don't you ever fight me.
Careful now, Jet's got some big biceps. Got some big biceps. But yeah, back on the topic. Yeah. Zavolin says trust is very important. Zeta Wolf says, you know, trust is so huge that mine is very, very hard earned. I don't even think I've earned my own. Javoyan also says, how can you trust them not to cheat on you? It's all in the faith.
Okay, here's what really, really, for me, important thing for especially guys. I mean, it works both ways. It works definitely both ways, and I think that's one of the reasons why you went through breakup in your situation before, right? But definitely for guys, this one, trusting is the worst. If you don't trust someone, you know that basically is saying you don't have confidence. You don't have what it takes to keep the girl. You lack that confidence because you lack trust. If you were, her boob is way up here, man. What the hell? Because my hands are not drawing anymore. But if you didn't trust a person, then that means you feel like you can't keep the girl, and that's all you can do. Like, but if you trust the person, at the end of the day, you know the person's gonna be yours, and they go out, they do whatever, and you just have that air of confidence. Like I am scared. Like, seriously. You know, I think that in itself is very attractive. Like, confidence is very attractive. So if you're always constantly worried, then it's like, dude, why am I even around? Like, or not trusting me. So yeah, if you guys are not trustworthy, that's very unattractive. Both sides. It's almost clingy. Clingy too. Hold on, that's not right. This hand over here. This hand's over here. Yeah, this hand's totally not right. This doesn't work this way. This is stupid. But yeah. Put the elbow here. Hand out going this way. You have anything to add to that, trust? Steven, he is quiet again. He got cut off again. Yeah.
All right. Got some more comments. Boner, Monkey Milk says, Jet is a beach jock. Fire says, Jet is the bicep warrior. Okay, but we got some comments to the topic. No, right? Javoyan says, you know, she needs to earn my trust, just like how someone has to earn my respect. Twallop was on the opposite side. The Twallop says, I don't know, I'm the opposite. You have my trust until you give me a reason not to.
I think you should
respect people. You don't have to necessarily trust them, but you know, everyone should have your respect until they do something to give you a reason not to respect them or trust them.
Yeah, and that's how I look at it for just knowing and meeting people in general. If, like, you look at everyone like a kind of a blank canvas, you know what I mean? Kind of just, you don't know who they are, you know? They could be a great person, it could be a very terrible person. I had the tendency to just trust and like everybody I meet, it doesn't matter. And I learned the hard way, because eventually they'll take advantage of you. And
yeah, that's when you drop them.
You drop them, and you just drop them. But that's what you do. You give everybody kind of the shadow of the doubt. You don't know them. They don't know you. So there's always this, you know what I mean? It's like what we said. If you don't race, then how do you know you're going to win? And if you don't meet the person without judging them, then you never know if that person is going to be, like, your best friend. You never know.
Hey.
Hey! Hey! I don't like this. Hey! Something about it. Something about this. Bum, 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 bum. So funny. You notice that we turn to girls later on. You're like, what?
I didn't notice that until Gavoyan said, he's like, oh, Steven's more cuter than Jen the drawing. So what does that mean? I'm ugly in person?
Oh, he's saying in comparison to the... Whatever. Whatever.
I'm just playing.
Whatever.
I just didn't even notice. Oh, Gavoyan has a question for both of us. He says, yeah. Jet, you trust your girlfriend, Steven. You too. Go ahead, Jet. You answer first.
I trust my girlfriend every day, every single day. Because you know what? I'm Jet. I'm saying, that's all there is to it. Like, I don't care, like, what she, like, at the end of the day, she's mine, and she goes to work, and she's pretty much a tomboy. Goes again to how, you know, like, what really I'm attracted to. So, like, we were just good friends, and she has a lot of boyfriends, like, friends that are boys. And because she just gets along with boys better than girls, and that's how it's always been. But you know, like, I look at it like this: if I stop trusting her, does that mean that basically says there are other guys who can better me, that are better than me? But if I just sit back and just relax and trust her, that just means, like, you know what, I'm confident with myself and with who she is, and she does whatever she wants because, yeah.
Yeah, I agree with that. Me, yeah. I mean, the main thing too is, I think, like you said, it's very important to trust. And my girlfriend's never given me a reason not to trust her. So it goes both ways, you know. It's kind of like you give them trust, and they also trust you because, you know, you're also trustworthy.
Yeah.
So it goes both ways.
It goes both ways.
Gavoyan says, you're not ugly, Steven. If I was a girl, you'd be my crush. Oh gosh. And Anwar says, I would win any day if I fought Jet in a thumb wrestling match.
Oh!
That's a challenge. That's a challenge.
You want to see me? You probably beat me. My thumbs are pretty weak. Arm wrestling.
Biceps, though. Arm wrestling. Just arm wrestle instead.
Arm wrestle.
But yeah, how's the drawing coming? I'm just looking at it now. It looks pretty...
Taking too long.
What are you doing right now?
Just trying to figure out the shapes for the hair. It's taking too long. Like, before, I felt like her head was too big, and I'm just flipping it around, trying to get a good shape. So I'm not even worried about drawing.
That's so
I'm just
cool,
thinking about shape.
Dude, that's so cool. In the last hour, you've done that. Your speed has, like, gotten so amazing now.
What? Thanks. I just feel like, yeah, dude, I feel like I took too long. This should be done a long time ago.
Oh, thanks. Man, it's all good. I just know that you've been improving, man. Oh. Heard it before. You're more quicker now with your drawing.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, we got a question here from Deuce X Machina. Jed, what would you do if your girlfriend told you that she cheated on you?
What I do? What would I do?
What would you do?
If she told me she cheated on me, then I'm just like, I honestly, here's how I honestly would feel. I would be like, why? Pretty be pretty like upset, and I would be naturally angry, right? But then I would learn about what happened and just, you know, give her a break. I honestly would, and that's how I feel like I would handle it. I do one break. That's it. That's all the chance you get. After that, if you cheat again, it's just over. Simple. The end.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Me, man, on the other end. On my side, I think I would just be like, you know, it's over.
Yeah.
That's hard, man. Like, if someone does that, if someone cheats on you, it's kind of like, it's like maybe almost like in a sense, like they weren't satisfied with what you had in your relationship.
Yeah.
It's kind of like they would just be like, you know, they're looking for something else.
So that's
if they're
true.
Looking for something else. You know what I mean? And if they found it in that person, then just go ahead. Just, you know, leave me be with that person. Because after that, man, it's going to be hard. Like, if someone cheats on you and then, like, you get back together, God, the trust issues will be crazy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, how could you ever, like, be in, like, trustful with that person? But, oh, and also, Harsimran Singh says, which part of California do you live in, Jet?
I live in Sacramento. It's pretty much everywhere.
What the hell does that mean? It's pretty much everywhere.
Pretty much everywhere. Everywhere on the internet. I was considering like not saying it. Like I say, like, I live in California most of the time. But if you look around, you'll find out where I'm from.
But he asked, which part of California do you live in?
Yeah, I said Sacramento.
Ask me if you live on the internet.
No, but I know. But what I'm saying is, dude.
Go ahead, explain yourself.
I did. I said, like normally I would say I'm just in California, and I don't tell them that I'm from Sacramento because that's kind of, you know, a little more personal.
Like, oh, that's true.
It becomes more personal.
Everybody knows now.
But everybody knows now. And it's what I'm saying. It's everywhere, as in, like, I think it's on the Twitter. It says it, like, on my other stuff, too, so.
Oh, it's cool. Rec TM says, Steven, would you please kindly join another stream in the future if you have time? I must say that this was rather entertaining to listen to while drawing. If you like me here, I think I will join in the future. The only thing that's kind of hard is me and Jed is, like, our time difference. We're on 16 hours difference from each other, like, time-wise. I'm in the Philippines, and Jet's all the way in California.
Yeah.
Nina Nerdface says, I'm taking bets on if Jet ends the stream before it reaches the two-hour mark.
What?
She's taking bets to see if you're going to end the stream before it hits 2 hours. But what else? Javorian says, hey, are you ever going to do a meetup, Jet? Because he's also from California. And also, Harsimran, the guy who asked you where you live from in California, he said, cool, I live about 2 hours away from you.
Oh, cool, man. Yeah, I would definitely do a meetup soon. I'm going to be doing conventions. Yeah. I'm going to be doing, like, the art conventions. So, Anime Expo, that's probably a place I'm going to go to. Go to, like, some comic book conventions. I'll be around.
Yeah, man, that'd be cool.
And I'll post it up.
Super Loser says, whoa, you live so close to me. And Boner Monkey Milk says, hey, us Californians have to stick together. Like, a lot of people from California in here. You know, I'm originally from California, but I've been transplanted to Manila. And Anwar Codice comes back and he says, you know what, if someone cheated on me, I would start dating Netflix.
What?
I guess that's a solution. I mean, if someone cheated on me, I'd probably start dating... I don't know. I'd probably start dating Jed. That's what it would be, because if I was not in a relationship, I'd probably always be hanging out with you.
Yeah.
Me and Jed are, like, hella best BFFs.
Yeah.
I mean, this dude just comes over to my house. Like, and it's funny, because I did this to my girlfriend. The first thing I did when I went in her house was I opened her refrigerator, and she got mad. She's like, what the hell are you doing? I'm like, I'm looking in your refrigerator, and she's like, that's so rude. And I was surprised, and I was like, but that's what me and my best friend do. And then she's like, oh, okay. Oh. Yeah, she didn't like that, but she knows now. She's kind of used to it. I told her, though, I wouldn't do it, though. But I can't help it. It was me and Jed, dude. Like, the first thing I do in Jed's house.
You gotta know what's
house,
in the fridge, man.
Exactly.
What's in the fridge?
But it's funny, because as soon as I go inside his refrigerator, I start complaining. I'm like, Jed, why don't you have that ice cream I like? where's the soy milk? Why'd you eat all the ice cream?
Yeah.
Why'd you save me some? It's funny.
Yeah.
We got Winter Sonic up in here. He says, shout me out. Winter Sonic, I'm shouting at you. What's up?
Winter Sonic!
We got people everywhere. Swallup is a Florida girl. She's all the way in Florida. Ali Raspberry is not even from America. Fire is from New Zealand. We got people all over the place. But yeah, I definitely think you should go to those meetups. And you should let me come with you.
I will.
Oh, Boner Monkey Milk says, hey, Jet, do you live in the ghetto?
I can't say that. That's too much information. But yeah, I do. I live in a ghetto. Born and raised in the ghetto. Steven did too. That's how we know each other.
Yeah, me and Jet live like down the street from each other. Off that. For real? Oh, that's right. We shouldn't say that.
You shouldn't say that. That's what the news reporters end up at your house like last time.
We live at the for real. No, but me and Jet live like down the street from each other. Basically. Hello, dude. I live like 5 minutes away from your house.
Yeah. We do.
He calls my mom. I call his mom.
Yeah.
How close we are. It's like a funny, I thought Jet was Filipino the first time I met him. I thought you were Filipino.
Yeah, most people do. Most people think I'm Filipino.
Yeah, you can tell I'm from California. I'm using hella.
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 Hella. Hella, 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 hella.
Such a NorCal thing to say hella. Huh. But yeah, I hella thought you were Filipino the first time I met you.
Yeah. But I thought you were Chinese. Good. I was like, this guy Chinese.
I am Chinese.
I'm like, dude, you like a ching-a-chang, a ching-a-chang. You know?
That's hella. Yeah, that's hella racist, but... And you're Chinese too, dude. Like, you act like you're not Chinese. You're part Chinese.
Part Chinese. I'm not Chinese.
We're both
Chinese.
Like 1/4 Chinese.
That's true. I'm actually like 75. No, sorry. Like a third.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
I'm 1/4.
Yeah.
Faya says, Jalapeno. Hella Filipino. I hella thought he was Filipino.
Damn it, I'm just gonna fix this. You see what I'm doing right now? Okay, so people will understand this. They're drawing, right? If they know anything about drawing, they know what's going on. I'm trying to freaking lasso this color here, but there's so many different colors going on, so I can't lasso it and pick the color. I'm trying to change the color, but since they're on the same layer, it's making it difficult for me, so I'm just gonna try to paint them all more solidly like this, but yeah. Any questions you got? Any questions? We're probably gonna...
I don't see any questions.
Good.
Oh, Nina Nerfus says, can we please get Jet singing Jetty from the Block?
I don't know Jetty from the Block. I'm the same OG, but I ain't from the Block.
RecTM90 says, he's from the northern parts of Sweden. In a village at winter, and in an apartment in the city at summer. Both places have high-speed internet. I start shaking and get fever if my internet is worse than 100 megabytes. Whoa. Sweden. Damn, that internet is fast. You know, one of the fastest internet I've ever experienced is when I went to Korea.
Yeah.
Korea has insanely fast internet. And I was just in the airport on their Wi-Fi. And their Wi-Fi is stupid fast. It's so fast. I think there's another question for you, Jet. Mm-hmm. Nina Nerdface says, do you have any experience with working in CMYK for designs?
No, never. I know
what
that.
What is that? What is that? I don't even know what that is.
A cyan. Using cyan.
Like a secret art thing?
Kinda, yeah. It kinda is. It's a secret. No, it's not a secret. It's just the colors they use usually for like print. Because printers are annoying when you're trying to switch colors back and forth to get the colors to match exactly. Printing is different from painting and like digital. But I think they've solved it with today's technology now. But it used to be the norm, and I don't have any experience with that because I always use RGB, which is red, blue, and red, green, and blue. That's all it is. I'm saying that's all it is. That's all it is. That's all it be.
That's all it be.
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna add some shadows, make it look more better. I like using skin tones for shadows. I don't know why. I think it just looks good. Sometimes I use bluish colors. But let's see here. So that's a shadow. Got a shadow.
So.
That hand is broken, but go with it. No, I'm not. I like to say I will, but I won't.
Oh yeah, thanks.
His hand is so broken. Goodness gracious. Dude, we out of topics now?
What's up?
We out of topics?
Oh, sorry. I was looking at recipes of chicken. My bad.
Oh, Stephen. You on a show, man.
Yeah, I got distracted from chicken. Okay. Oh, we got some more people. How does that work? Anwar says, I'm Canadian but American. Is that even possible? That sounds illegal. I'll explain it. Yo, Chip. Javolian asked, when are you going to do a hangout with the fans?
I will. Shoot, that's one of the things I'm going to freaking do. I also owe people some drawings, you guys. If you're one of those people, I'm sorry. I still owe you a drawing. But it's either stream or draw. I gotta stream and draw or work. Stream, draw, or work. One of those.
You should do a hangout and draw people. I used to tell Jed to draw me, and then he'd get mad because I kept moving.
I remember that.
Stop moving, Steven. I can't jar you when you keep moving.
Remember that.
But then I move a lot.
This hand is retarded, but I'm just gonna stick with it.
Winter Sonic has asked you, hey Jet, do you like the movie I, Robot?
Oh shoot, I gotta watch that.
Oh, okay. Have you
seen it?
I guess you can't. Yeah. Wait, is that the one with Will Smith?
No, I think
I think it's the new one.
It is?
No, it's the one with Will Smith. It's like in the future. And then it has to deal with like artificial intelligence, like in robots.
Yeah, there's a new one though that's out. Yeah, Chappie, never mind. You're right. iRobot.
Oh, there is?
Yeah, Chappie. It's like the same theme, but it's not about like who killed who, I think. It's just about the robots got emotions and they're trying to legalize it and stuff and dealing with the legal
something
issues.
Like that. Yeah.
Getting hunted down or something. That's a Chappie.
Ooh, okay, you got some more questions, Jet.
Okay.
Twalip says, yo, Jet, any new projects you're excited about working on? If you can tell us about it.
Yeah. Heck yeah, I'm so excited. Man, dude. I haven't mentioned it at all, but I'm working on... Well, I mentioned it on another stream. It's this game called... I'm not supposed to say the name, but I'm doing all the characters and all of the sprites and characters for the game. It's going to be like over 50 characters. It's crazy. Just basically doing all the artwork for it. Yeah, it's a big, big project. Excited about it. Same company I worked for last time. I will be doing a stream where I draw some more stuff from that thing. Wait. Yeah. See, let's give you
we
guys
should a do moment. A stream yeah. where you draw like that stuff and then I'll just draw stick figures on the side.
We can do that.
I'll show like the art of stick figures.
We could do that.
I don't know if I get a lot of views though.
I mean, you get plenty of views.
Joe Hernandez says, Jed, when you are just starting out in art drawing, should one try everything to see what I would like to master?
Try everything? I usually would try what I'm interested in. Unless you want to be like jack of all trades, then yeah. I know that there are a ton of different fields, right? And people who like drawing animals, trains, buildings, houses, characters, monsters. What are you interested in? If you're interested in trains, draw trains. There's a story I told before about this guy who works for Pixar in the past, and this is for my teacher who worked for Pixar. He said that all he drew was trains during his art school, and he ended up getting a job because he was so good at it and proficient. It's like, you know, it's not for everybody, but if you're into it, then do it. So, yeah. But definitely learn, if you want to get into, like, character design and stuff, you know, just only makes sense to learn character, figure drawing and
stuff. So I guess basically go with what you enjoy doing, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
I got another question. Two more questions. Chad, the color you're using for the shadows, how did you pick it? Like, what's the darkness value and saturation and warmness?
Like I said! The color that I use, tend to use for simple color for shadows is the skin tone that you see, like the very skin tone here. Her skin tone is the color that I'm actually using. So this one here. See, if I just clicked on this one, her cheek, and then I set the layer above it to multiply, and I just paint above it, it gives us a really nice doubling effect. But it's a really nice warm shadow. If I wanted to go more cooler, can. It just depends on your preference. It's not a matter of what's right and wrong. Like, it's just preference. Like, see, this is purple, and that gives another kind of feeling. But it's definitely not super dark. Like, it's not too dark. You know, because I feel like this may be too dark, and it's too far away from the base color. It's so far away, and colors, shadows being that dark is only in small situations. So maybe a little bit darker, so you jump out a little more. Yeah. Yeah. So I just adjust it by eye. And it's constantly always ongoing. But I hope that answered your question.
Yeah. Oh, another question came in. Superloser 1995 says, sometimes I just don't feel like drawing. Have you ever felt the same way, Jet?
Yeah. Yes, sir. I'm just like tired. I'm like, I don't want to draw. I'm tired, man. But then I look at all the stuff that people are doing, and I'm like, you know, while I'm resting, they're drawing. So I'm like, I gotta get back on it, you know.
Exactly.
I'm not trying to fall behind. So while you're resting, there's others out there working. But rest is very important. Very important. That's probably the most important part in growing. It helps your body or your mind. Grow. It helps you grow. The time that you take off is really important because. Sorry, somebody talked in the background. It allows your like when you're working out. If you can't work out for days and days and not rest, because when you stop, that's when your body rests and it has time to grow the new muscles. The same with drawing. If you're practicing drawing, if you don't rest, you won't see the improvements until you stop. Once you stop, you know, if you're frustrating with something for a long time, and you're just having a hard time with drawing, give it a break. Stop for a day and then come back. The drawing will be a little easier because you allowed that time to rest. And that's
I think that's a good point. I think, like with anything, you have to take a step back every now and then.
Yeah. Let's go this way. So, I'm going to do some highlights for their hair, and I'm probably going to work on this a little bit more after the show's over, and then post it up somewhere, I don't know. Somewhere. It'll be in the link.
Someday. Oops.
So how that drawing going along?
It's okay. Oh, that's a skin layer. We gotta put some skin there. Some more shadows.
Oh, you got a question for Jet.
Yeah.
Jet, do you ever think to yourself, wow, I'm a great artist?
No. No, not really. I don't think I'm that good. That's the problem. Like, I think I'm decent. Like, I think I'm above average. But, like, I think in relation to the people I know, I constantly say I'm not good enough. That's the thing. Like, I'm constantly saying I need more work. Like, I could be doing so much more. Yeah, it's never really that feeling. I say, wow, I've improved. I do say that. I say that a lot. I go, ooh, I've improved. I'm moving forward.
Yeah. I think everyone right now in the chat is talking about drawing and getting better. Yeah. Javolian says, you know, you should probably force yourself to draw a bit every day, just like even 10 minutes. Everyone has 10 minutes out of their day. Yeah, what do you think is maybe one of the best ways to improve your artistic ability, Jet?
Yeah.
I'm sure it doesn't necessarily mean you have to always be drawing. I'm sure just going to workshops, watching other people draw can help too, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that right there is what we call developing kind of a visual library. Because a person visual library in that somebody who sees the world, you know, we'll see things differently than the person who hasn't seen the world. You haven't experienced things. So just being alive and experiencing life will help you in your drawing. Here's an example. Someone who has muscles versus somebody who doesn't. People who have muscles who are good at drawing learn how to draw muscles really easy. Because they have the muscles and they can just feel it in their drawing. It's not even that they're looking at it; they just feel how it works. And this is a okay. Like I see a lot commonly with girls, they have trouble drawing muscles. For boys.
And oh, is that so? In general,
yeah, that is true. It's a lot of times, not just sometimes. I mean, a lot. I've noticed it.
Okay.
So. For me, it just came pretty naturally. You know, I'm not like a super muscular guy, but I have some muscle, so it helped. And that's just because I've experienced the muscle. So yeah. What's the question again? Oh yeah, drawing every day.
Question. Well, I was just asking.
The original.
I was saying, like, what do you think is like the best ways to like keep improving? Because I think that's what everyone's talking about right now.
Yeah.
They're talking about like how they improve, how they stay on their game. Some people are talking about like, you know, yeah, maybe you should take a day off every now and then, like especially if you don't feel like drawing.
Drawing, it's definitely important to always keep drawing, and that's just common sense, you know. Like you wanna be good at basketball, keep shooting hoops, you know what I mean. But again, you gotta take breaks.
Yeah, I think that's the main thing. Yeah, you should take a break every now and then.
Yeah. Breaks are equally as important. Something about your eyebrows, man. No?
Huh. Fire says, Jet, master at drawing biceps.
Motorboat. Motorboat. Go so fast.
So we got another question in. Question. I'm currently transitioning from traditional into digital, and I'm having a hard time adjusting to my tablet. Do you have any tips for getting accustomed to a tablet besides mileage? How do you get used to
tablet? How to get used to tablet. I actually did a video on that. I mentioned everything that I talk about in getting used to tablet. Inking and drawing lines is a good way to improve. And yeah, I'm sorry, but there's really no other way around it other than the mileage thing, because it depends on how much drawing have you clocked in your life. If you just practice it every day. A good one is if you just practice drawing like inks. I'm gonna show you right now. So if I were to go back into these lines are rough. They're not clean at all. So if I were to go back in, turn off all these layers, and turn on the opacity and just really try to get these lines, try to hit it like this. So if I were to try to ink it, basically, I would try to get every single line right, and that just helps with hand-eye coordination and control, and requires tablet. There's that. And the way you would do it, there's a process to it. You would zoom in. That's an easy one to do. Zooming in, right? That's kind of straightforward. Zooming in. And hitting undo will help you go back, you know what I mean? Trust me, it used to take me days. I've been like days, just like trying to get that line like over and over and over. But here's how you would kind of approach it. There's a way you can look at the line, just move the hand over the line. It's called ghosting, and kind of sync your brain with the screen. Instead of trying to anticipate it, look at it, 1, 2, 3, and then do it, 1, 2, 3, then do it. You know, that's how I would look at it. Every time you go 1, 2, 3, you're kind of anticipating and synchronizing your brain, because it's not a direct contact like it is with paper. You know, rotating for Manga Studio, you can rotate your canvas. I'm sure you can with Photoshop too, but if you press shift and then spacebar, you can rotate, whoop-de-doo, and you can rotate it. Get your hand in a comfortable position. One of the most comfortable is from upper right to left, like this. This is not so much, this is kind of a lifting motion, but everything's kind of this arc. So if you get into that arc position, it's kind of this natural angle. And also, the process. It is a process, so if you have a nice rough draft, then it's going to be easier. If you have a really messy rough draft, then it's going to be harder. So how do you fix that? You just do several layers. Maybe the first layer was like hair was like this, you know what I mean? Like that was the first one. And then the second one, maybe the second one looks like my rough draft. And then the third one would be the clearest, cleanest ink. And that right there is everything that you can do to improve your line art.
I think a lot of people are commenting right now on anatomy. Like people are having problems with curves. People are having problems drawing hips, boobs. Curves. A lot of people are saying curves. Like, I guess maybe how do you get curves? Is that just like more about studying anatomy? Like, so I remember one thing. I remember you used to take those drawing classes before where you used to draw people like naked people. I thought you were.
But yeah, that's what I did.
Like, why do you always have to draw people naked? Why?
Because to be naked. Okay, curves in on people, or are we talking about curves on with your hand, like being able to curve your pen, like I was saying. That's a matter of like getting again like in comfort, and like if you have a bigger if you're drawing in a canvas, you would use your shoulder. If you're in a sketchbook, just this long kind of swipe across, long broad strokes, and say if you have to cover a long distance, like from this arm to here, it's going to be harder if it's a longer stroke, right? So this is going to be, you'll use a shoulder kind of motion. But if I was to zoom out a little bit, give it right here. Right. No, that's not good. That's okay right there. Then I would have less distance to cover. So it's about how you approach it. And these, the color for these lines are stupid still. Yeah, let's just go black. Because these lines being light like that, stupid. Since it is flat anime, anyway. I think that's what's been bugging me this whole time. The thickness, the darkness of that line.
So I have blue hair in this picture.
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. I guess I'm a pretty girl. I've always wondered that, if I was ever a girl, what I would look like if I was a girl.
There you go.
I think I'd be a pretty girl.
That's you, man.
I just wonder if I would have big boobs. Or a big That's all I wonder.
That's give you
every single day.
Every day. Dude. I'm drawing. Ooh.
Rec TM hits us with a fun fact. Fun fact. Psycho drew a chick with a dick on stream before. Jetty remembers.
I can't co-sign that. Can't co-sign that.
Oh, no.
Can't co-sign
that. Oh, we've hit the 2-hour mark.
Am I?
Being a nerd face. She called it. Yep, we hit the 2-hour mark. She called it like an hour ago.
No way.
She's like, I bet you guys Jet goes over the 2-hour mark. She's right.
She's always right, man. I never stick to the time. Will someday. But yeah, this stream will come to an end in like 10 minutes. In like 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, it's like coming to an end. Make your eyes bigger. Let's go super duper anime. Let's do the super duper doop. Super dip. Super dip. Super days. If I go bigger, I gotta go one more towards the right. Oh. Oh, shoot. The other side's gotta be bigger, too. Okay, all right. Okay, all right. Let's put some highlights in the eye. After the highlights, it's coming to an end. Say goodbye. What else we got, Steven? What else we got? Are you looking at cake again or chicken? What are you looking at?
Food? Yeah.
Steven, you're like Becky. Yeah. I mean, Boogie Monster.
I get distracted by food.
Hey, Boogie Monster, are you watching this?
The Devoyan said, one stream with Steven, he said 30 minutes, and it went for 2 hours. That's funny.
What did he say?
He said one time we were supposed to have a stream, it was supposed to be 30 minutes, but it went on for 2 hours.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember that. What's that sound you're making? I thought you were having a seizure. What's going on? Seizure sounds. So, in Manga Studio, you can basically select the color from your layer or the color that you see, depending on whichever one you want. I mean, it's a lot faster if you wanted to find a color. Shoot. For example, if I wanted this shadow color, and I want to pick it up, but it's already been multiplied. If it's multiplied, then you're not getting the color that you want. So I'm going to set it over here just by going to the color picker, looking at the options over here, and just clicking color picker from layer. So I'm going to be picking the underneath color, which is a light shade of purplish red. But if I didn't, and I just picked up the color that you see, and you picked that up instead, it's actually darker. So when you go on top of it, it's even darker than that. So it's nice if you just have this color picture from the layer. It's always good. But I want from just the regular color picture for now. Okay, let's see. What? That's not like my nose, though, I don't think. Make that. He's got the European nose. Because you're mixed.
Yeah. Is.
You're a half-breed.
I'm a tri-breed.
Yeah, sure.
I have three bloods going through my veins.
But then two of those are from Asia.
I have two Asian bloods and one from Europe.
And one
I am a tri-blood. Like your friend, remember he was doing the Transformers?
Yeah.
He was like, Autobots, roll out.
CT. If you guys know CT, he's got the craziest
Autobots. He's on YouTube, right?
He's a little bit, his music's on YouTube. He's mostly just famous for being a good artist. He doesn't even need to be on YouTube to be popular. Yeah. Oh.
Pineapple. I like to eat pineapple.
I like to
Christopher Walken, that's so hard.
Oh yeah, Christopher Walken?
Hey, it's the Jetty Jet Show.
Yeah. Hi, Jetty Jet Show. Doing now. It's pretty good. Jetty Jet Show. Ah, Christopher Walken. I gotta use the toilet. Dang, that's bright highlights. It's too bright. Too bright. I'm gonna turn it down. Yeah. No better. A little better. A little bit better. Hi, ciao, Steven. Let's put some lashes there. Maybe lashes are too much overpowering. Too much. There. Dang. But this mouth is bugging me still. Steven, you disappeared, man. All right. Looks like Steven's gone. I'm gonna wait till he gets back. Once he gets back, this show is over. Show is ending. Because this is gonna go on forever. I just lose track of time. Alright, check it out. Mainly Krita is confusing for me. Jet, have you ever used Glow Dodge layered in one of your picks? Glow Dodge?
I use a color dodge. Glow Dodge? Let's see what you mean. Glow Dodge. That's weird. It's pretty much the same as color dodge, I'm guessing. Looks like it. I'm using color dodge still, by the way, so. Wait, no, that's color dodge. Color burn? Not really. I'm just going to stick with color dodge for now. And yeah, her, she looks like all that smudginess on her face. Those girls look like Makoto Kino, on the left looks like Rei Hino. Awesome. Thanks. I'm not sure who they are, but yeah, that's who they look like. I'll have to check that out. I'll have to check it out. This will lower her shoulder down a bit because her shoulder is so up there. Let's see here. Just these lines are bugging me a little bit. Ah. So yeah, I'm working on a lot of projects right now: manga, comic, and some furniture, house, like architecture designs. And also some fairies. So I got a lot of work to do, and it's really good to just stop for a second and just work with you guys or just draw for you guys. It is fun.
Hey,
I think they missed you.
Sorry. My internet.
All good.
My internet be dying.
Something about her, man.
This drawing. Did you just give me a headband?
Yeah.
It's a red thing on my head.
Yeah, dog, you got a headband. How you gonna keep your hair up, dude? How are you going to keep your hair up? Steven? How are you going to disappear again? Huh? It's like that, son. Alright. Let's put some,
I'm right here. Internet be dying, though.
It's alright.
That's straight.
Internet.
So I'm guessing you're putting up the finishing touches right now?
Finishing touches, yep. Something's bugging me. Maybe it's this shadow here. Depressing. Yeah, I think that was it. Before, after. It's a little touch right there. It changes her expression. This is like tired. I've been working too long. This is like happy. It's good to hear her eyes.
Dang, that's so cool. So that's us in girl form.
That's us girl form. That's girl form us.
We some pretty girls. Fire. We are back with the Steven Silva Show.
All right.
No. This is the Jetty Jet Show. Featuring Steven Silva.
There we go.
Whoa, what the heck?
That's the brown I'm looking for.
Sounds kind of romantic. Otaku commented earlier, I need advice. How can I recharge my artistic motivation? I don't draw anymore. Some people have said try to change the scenery. Download a shit ton of references. Turn on some music. Turn off the lights if you have to. Light a candle. Get in the flow. Turn on some music. That sounds romantic. It sounds like the recipe to Valentine's date. Oh, no. Otaku says, me, my life is a wreckage. I can't keep up with the happiness that made me draw anime.
Oh, why?
Well, I wonder why. Yeah, I mean, find what made you happy in the first place. Jet, why'd you make your boobs bigger than mine? Why are your boobs bigger than mine?
Why is my boobs bigger than yours? It's more evident. Yours is being tucked away, man. All right, fine. We'll try to emphasize it with this line here. This line here to do the trick. All right.
All right. Let's just make my boobs big, but like concealed. All
right. All right. Let's make them big. Watch this. So the flow
of the. Some girls do that. I don't know how. Some girls do that. Some girls have really big breasts, but they conceal them really well. I know that's really off topic, but yeah.
That's not off topic. That's right on. We are on it.
Yeah, that's art. Yeah, I'm talking about art.
Dude, I'm drawing boobs right now. It's on topic.
Yeah. All right, I'm not a pervert. Yeah.
Okay, so this is really good because the flow of form on top of form. This is one of the techniques or tricks you can use to kind of exaggerate shapes. A lot of times design, what's driving your design? And I was trying to find that word last time. The drive of design sometimes is not really the concept itself. It's actually the design itself is what's driving it. So by that I mean like, if I wanted to draw like a suit, like say an armor or body armor or some sort of swimsuit or any kind of outfit, the lines, the seam lines, like this seam line right here, the only reason, like one of the biggest reasons why I put it down is because it really helps show the curvature of the arm. If I were to put another curvature here, that'll show that's the direction of that arm. If I put some stripes on there, it really helps to show how the form is. And if I were to design, like, for example, like a biker's jacket or a plug suit for like a robot's plug suit or something, the lines all the inside the drawing is really dictated by the drawing itself, and the design is being driven by the forms that I want to emphasize. So right now, I'm trying to draw bigger boobs, and to do that, I'm changing the direction of these lines a bit. See the curves right here, which is wrong, but if I did this here and I exaggerated that drop, now watch how that changes the direction of her shirt, as well as giving him bigger boobs. Now, so let's see. Okay, let's have shape, less 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 shape.
How come my boobs are blurry now?
Your boobs are blurry because it's a round object. So the form softens the top end, but the bottom end, the part where it cuts off and becomes a harder form, or hard edge. Matt, you're not internet, Thompson.
Oh no.
Yeah,
mama.
Yeah. I think she wants to give me some food or something.
Mama. Oh, talk about that my man.
No. That was some good made up language though. Whatever it was.
Actually, it's not made up Cambodian. Just like you have your made up Tagalog.
Yeah. Except I just say sakit kaayo. Sakit kaayo.
Oh, we got some people leaving. Hey, no problem, RecTM90. Thanks for dropping by.
I'm finishing it up with a kind of a bold kind of outline. I think that's a good way to pop it forward. Yeah. Sometimes my stream's going too long. Too long!
Six Design says, hi, Jetty Mom. Patrick Donnelly says, hey, Jet, what was your thick eyebrowed friend?
Dude, Jet, Cynics. Cynics is another YouTuber.
Oh, is he?
He's a big time YouTuber.
Oh, cool.
Funny ass guy. Cynics. He's too big for this show. That's why he won't join.
Oh,
nah,
no.
I told him it would just be me and you. We actually were talking earlier. You guys get the idea. I'll outline all that later. I think that's going to be it for now, because it's going to keep going and going.
Yeah, I think I have to go. I haven't even eaten.
You haven't eaten?
I just woke up. Since I woke up, I jumped on the stream.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's right. Hold on a sec. Hold on a sec. You gotta stick for a second, man.
Hold up.
Hold up. Hold up. Hold up. Hold up.
Hold up. Hold up. Hold up.
Hold up. Hold up. We them boys.
We them boys.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to do. So that's that. And then... Man, I don't like forcing cleavage in when it's hard to put in. It's like, see, like...
Oh, dude, you don't have to.
No, what I'm saying is, I'm trying to show, like, people... Okay, design, like I said, form will design your drawing for you. So, like, don't try to force it in if it doesn't work out in the form itself. So, like, if I were to put in a cleavage right there, that just messes up the, well, let's see, the shape, or the shape of her breast. It says, like, the line would be somewhere else. So you can't just, like, automatically just say, oh, that's the opening, therefore I have to put it there. No, it actually would kind of be right here. Sometimes it's just difficult to put in unless you make it work, but it can't be forced.
Cynic says, I love forcing cleavage.
No, you don't. You don't love doing that.
Devorian says... You should make Cynics a girl next, Jet. Man, we some hot nerd. What are we? Are we like nurses or maids? We look hot here.
I don't know. We just got dress shirts on because it was easy to draw in.
Man, I like how I look. I'm a decent looking girl.
Yeah, funny.
You don't ever think about that? What you would look like if you were a girl?
No.
I think about it at least once a week. At least once a week. I'm just kind of curious. I'm just like, man. What would happen? What would happen, man? That one chromosome wasn't what it was. I forget how it works.
It's X.
I remember studying it. XX is a girl, right? XX. It's a girl, and XY is a boy.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Yeah, that's right. What if that other chromosome was an X and I was a girl? Man, I wouldn't be Steven.
You wouldn't be Steven. You would be...
Stephanie! I wouldn't be Steven, I'd be Stephanie! And I wouldn't have to sing a falsetto! Because
I have a girl voice.
I wouldn't have to do falsetto. Because I have a girl voice. I have a smaller Adam's apple.
And you'd have some mega bitties.
Oh, God. Dance of Shiny says, Steven looks hot. Jed looks like the ugly friend.
Oh! Ho, ho.
Oh, no.
Oh, hell no.
And then Cynic says, Cynic's popped in. He says, I think about what Jed would look like as a girl every night. It was funny. The chat's getting hilarious. Cynics would look great in high heels. The Kisho says, if I was a female, I'd never leave the house.
All right. I think that's it. I think I'm satisfied with this drawing. You know, even if it's a simple, like, flat 2D kind of drawing, it's so complicated to have something I'm freaking satisfied with. It's just hard. Difficult, man. Steven.
Tell him. That's hard, man.
Tell him.
Art's not easy. Art is life, man. Art is not easy. Art is life. Art is easy. Art is what you want it to be.
Tell them.
I'm telling them, man. Art is like a box of pizza. You know what I'm saying? So many different toppings. So many
That's what I'm saying. Tell them.
I'm telling them. They don't know. I'm trying.
Steven.
I'm trying to tell them, man. I'm trying to tell them.
They don't know, you know what I'm saying? Steven.
Guys, listen up. Art is like pizza, man. So many different toppings. So many different styles. It's all on you what you want it to be. That's art.
Hey! That's tight. Yeah.
That
was tight. Pizza like art. Art is like pizza. All the toppings.
You know what I'm saying?
Get
stuffed crust.
Mm-hmm.
Get extra cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Get deep dish. Javonian says art is whatever. Art is what you make it.
And Steam just disappeared. Wow. All right, this time I'm not lying. I'm leaving. I'm leaving, all right? All right, I'm leaving you guys for sure. And we'll be back soon. Thanks a lot for joining the show. Steven, man. Oh, shit. I want him to say goodbye with you guys. With. That would be cool. So. Maybe wait till he comes back. But this time, when he comes back, for sure. There you are, Steven. Steven.
I'm here.
About to say goodbye now.
Well, that's right.
Yeah, we're going to say goodbye because it's going on for too long. People are sick. Not like that, Steven. Come back. Steven. This is crazy. Hopefully next time it won't be as bad. I'll wait for you, Steven. Don't worry. I'll wait for you. Now, this one doesn't really do that kind of curve. I mean, that those kind of lines because it's being pressed this way. So the lines would be going this way here. Okay. That's it. All right, I'm going to read you guys' comments. Hopefully, Steven will show up during that time. And, we don't want you to leave, Senpai, Steven. We don't, Steven. Come back. Steven, come back, Steven. Steven, don't leave us. We're going to say goodbye to everybody. I see you guys' comments like popping up in the corner of my eye. I see it. I do see it. Something about this line here. Steven, you're back, dude. Oh,
I'm sorry, man. Joe, you're right. My web is such a troll. It's killing me.
It's a troll.
I'm sorry. Internet be killing me.
So I said to them that when you come back, I was going to leave for real. All right?
Oh, yeah.
You know what that means?
It's time to say goodnight.
No, you know what that means?
Time to say goodbye.
Wait a second.
What does that mean?
It means I gotta put some color for this t-shirt here.
Oh, okay. All right.
Put a white down for this shirt, and then we'll go, for sure. But yeah, I think, yeah, you can say goodbye. You can say goodbye. Say this to the final thoughts, and read maybe the final comments, and then...
Well, let's see. Drag Germani says, Steven's breasts are huge. Love it. RecTM90 says, Jet, could you start calling him Steven instead? He wants people to call me PHTVN. He said, imagine though, if everyone started calling you Steven. Basically, that's a world where everyone has a lisp. They can't say Steven, they say Steven.
Oh, Steven.
I can't even see the picture anymore. People keep telling me my boobs are great. Steven's got double D's. Steven's got triple C's. Those are at least triple D's. I can't see my boobs.
You're gonna outdo my boobs, Steven? You're gonna outdo my boobs, huh?
Hey, you drew them.
I'll show you. How dare you?
You drew them, man.
I'll show you, buddy. You ain't ever outdo my boobs.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm not the one drawing.
Oh, no, that looks retarded. Hold on. Steven, you there? You there, man? There, brother. I just don't like the fact that sometimes boobs are just so in your face, like, these are boobs. Look at the boobs. You know?
It's got to be in the face.
It's got to be subtle, man. Classy. Classy.
Yeah, definitely. But yeah. So I think we should probably end this then.
We should. Hold on a sec. We should definitely end this next. All right. We're good. You happy with your boobs, Steven? I'm happy with my boobs. Really? Okay. WS, it, get it, haha, so funny. Punny started a breast battle. They look like 36Bs to me, boobs. I don't even know the numbers. I don't understand how boobs work. But that's pretty much it for the show, you guys. Thanks so much for joining. And Steven, thanks so much for joining. It's an awesome show, even though you got kicked off like 100 times. Steven, you there?
I'm here.
Steven, you gotta hear me? I can hear you.
I'm here.
You gotta stick with me, man. You gotta stick with me.
About I'm here, man. I'm not going anywhere. I'm here.
But Steven, stick with me, right?
I'm here.
All right. We're gonna say goodbye now. You say bye.
Yes, all right. Thanks for having me. Thanks for tuning in, everybody.
Yeah.
It was fun. Let's do it again soon.
All right, let's see. Where's the stop the hangout button at? All right, everybody, this is Jet signing off, and this was the Jet Show. Take care, keep drawing, and always, peace.